You know, there are times where I make videos that just don't make any sense, but for whatever reason, they're entertaining and hysterical in their own way. Like when I removed all of the stone from World Generation just to see the chaos that ensued. Link to that video can be found above. And while today's video isn't quite as extreme as that one, ultimately, I'm making this video for fun. Today, I want to know how to increase your chances for being struck by lightning in Minecraft. Because you never know, one day it might wind up becoming an achievement, and let's be real, it's kind of an achievement all on its own. I've been playing Minecraft for 6 years, 9 months, and 14 days, and I've only ever been struck by lightning once. And funny enough, it was on video during my death swap with Log.Zip. Fun times. But anyways, let's check out how to best prepare yourself to be struck by lightning in survival Minecraft. Okay, let's get into this. What is the most optimal way to be struck by lightning in survival Minecraft? Well, first things first, we need to understand a little bit more about how lightning strikes in Minecraft. And honestly, it's pretty simple. During any given thunderstorm, on any block that rain falls on top of, there is a 1 in 100,000 chance per tick per chunk that lightning will strike the ground. So with that in mind, I originally had the thought that if you load as few chunks as possible, you would increase your chances of being struck, because there would be less surface area for lightning to strike. But that's not necessarily true either. For instance, if you only had one single chunk loaded, there'd be a 1 in 100,000 chance for a lightning strike per tick. If you had 100 chunks loaded, there'd be 100 times the surface area for lightning to strike, but it'd also be 100 times more likely for lightning to spawn at all because it's per chunk per tick. So with all of that in mind, it just kind of evens out. Simply put, it doesn't matter how many chunks are loaded. So, what should we try next? Well, after diving deeper into the mechanics of thunderstorms in Minecraft, I found out that you will take damage from a lightning strike if you're within 3 blocks of it on the X and Z axis, and then there's some variance on the Y axis. But then, I found out another interesting tidbit of information. When lightning chooses a location to strike, before appearing and before hitting the ground, the game looks for any living entities that can see the sky within a 3x3 region that the lightning chose to strike. If any happen to exist within that region, yourself included, the lightning will instead strike that entity dead on. What that means is, you can slightly manipulate where lightning will strike and increase your chances of being struck altogether. Because of this fact, I had the idea to create what I'm gonna call a lightning farm. Think about it this way. If you're all alone, standing out in the middle of a field, at any given moment there is a 7x7 block area where lightning can strike and hit you. But what if, on the edge of that 7x7 area, you put a bunch of pigs? Again, keep in mind, if lightning strikes within a 3x3 block area of any living entity, the lightning will strike the entity dead on instead, sort of teleporting to that entity. So all of a sudden, we've increased our range for being struck by lightning from 7x7 to 13x13. If lightning strikes anywhere within this 13x13 area, it will deal damage to the player, either directly or indirectly, and as such, it'll count for this experiment. So I built this little contraption according to the math that I had worked out and just waited. And after about 4 in-game thunderstorms, it happened, and the contraption worked. As you can see from this footage, one of the pigs on the corner was directly struck by lightning. And because I was close enough to that pig, and by proxy the lightning bolt itself, I was also struck by lightning. So it works. If you want to be struck by lightning in survival Minecraft, this is the method that I would recommend. While this may not be absolutely 100% the most effective way to do this, it's certainly the best way that I could quickly figure out, given the information that was provided through the Minecraft Wiki. So before I go ending off this video, I just want to show you guys a little behind the scenes of sorts in how I set up this experiment and how I wound up confirming some of the numbers that I had for this video. So the first thing that I have in front of me here is just a little area that I set up in order to see how far away from lightning I could be before I would no longer be struck, and by proxy, how close to a lightning strike I had to be in order to take damage from it, both on the y-axis along with the x and z-axis. So again, all I have set up here is just this little tower of glowstone, which doesn't really mean much, but lightning is going to strike the block right above it, because if you look on the F3 menu, you can see that it says that I am looking at -22.6, -796. So if I go ahead and I type in this command here, you can see that lightning is going to strike the block right above it, which would sort of simulate the block that I am standing on. So yeah, let's go ahead and let's do that there. And you can see, as long as I type in that command, lightning is going to strike that exact spot every single time. So what I found out is that you can be standing somewhere around 9 blocks above the lightning strike and 3 blocks below it and still get struck. So let me go ahead and let me go over to game mode 0 here. And you can see that if I stand on the very, very, very edge of this here, then I'm actually not going to get struck by lightning at all. So yeah, I know visually it looks like the lightning might be striking on this platform, but it's not. It's going right through it. So anyways, if I go ahead and I step about a block closer and I summon lightning again, then I am going to get hit by lightning. Now, if I go one block too high, which is, I believe, somewhere around 9 or 10 blocks above the lightning strike, then I'm not going to get hit by lightning. Even if I go super, super close, I'm just not going to get hit. And if I go ahead and I stand right here, I'm going to get hit. So, yeah. All right, let's go ahead and let's go over to game mode 1, go down here. And I also discovered that you can be somewhere around 3 blocks below the lightning and not get struck as well, or rather 4 blocks below and not get struck. So if I go ahead and I summon the lightning here, you can see, there it is, bam, the lightning strikes. But if I go one block further up and I'm still within that 3-block area away from it, then I will get struck by lightning. So that did actually confirm to me that any entity that is going to get struck by lightning does have to be within 3 blocks of the lightning strike in order to take damage. And this really only applied for me because I just wanted to know how close I had to be to the actual lightning strike in order to be affected. So yeah, that's how I set up the initial experiment. Now beyond that point, I wanted to know about this whole experiment with lightning striking other mobs and then by proxy striking me instead. Because obviously the concept of lightning striking within like something like 6 blocks away from you, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, it can strike 6 blocks away from you with this setup and still hit you, but with this setup it can only be 3 blocks away from you. So obviously the latter seemed more appealing. So again, if I were to be standing right here and lightning struck this block, I would wind up getting hit by lightning, but if it struck this one, I wouldn't be, because the lightning wouldn't do the teleportation thing and teleport to me. So yeah, what I set up here is pretty much what you would have to set up for yourself if you wanted to get struck by lightning. So again, if lightning were to strike, say, this block right here, because the pig is within 3 blocks of it, the lightning would sort of teleport to the pig itself, and then the lightning would, instead of striking right here, it would actually strike the pig directly. Because again, the lightning strikes the entity dead on if it's within 3 blocks. Now, if lightning were to strike within this inner area, then I would just wind up getting hit directly. So, you know, it's gonna work out no matter what. If lightning strikes right here, it's gonna choose one of these 2 pigs to teleport to. If it strikes right here, it should still select one of those 2 pigs to teleport to. So let me go ahead and let me stand in the middle of the center square here. This whole area is 13 by 13, as I said in the video, and I have already tested this. I know that this is gonna work, but let me go ahead and let me head over to game mode 0 here, and let me go ahead and let me type in this command instead, where instead, what, let's see here, I think I need to tap up a couple of times. If I execute on some random pig within 10 blocks of myself and I summon a lightning bolt, let me go ahead and let me go into the F5 here. If I go ahead and I summon this lightning bolt here, then as you can see, it hit that pig back there and I got hit by the lightning strike. So let me go ahead and let me do this here, and you'll see it a little bit more directly since it won't be directly behind me here. Bam. So as you can see, lightning struck that pig dead on, and that does simulate what would happen if lightning were to strike somewhere within this region. It would teleport to the pig and the pig would get struck. So let me go ahead and let me do that 2 more times since we have 2 more pigs to go through. Bam. So as you can see, we get hit by lightning and that pig, well, he's not going to last very long because he's going to be dead. Bam. There we go. So if you want to get hit by lightning, this is the setup that I would recommend making. So yeah, that pretty much covers it. Feel free to give it a try for yourself. Let me know if it wound up working for you, or let me know if you have any other interesting experiments in mind that I can wind up testing out on video, because I'm always open to new ideas. So anyways, guys, I hope you all enjoyed this little experiment. If you guys did enjoy the video, then please consider leaving a like on it, because it would really help out myself, the channel, and the video quite a lot. So I hope you all enjoyed. My name is Ant Venom, and I bid you all farewell. Thanks so much for watching.